fold so that you do not leave this planet not one day before your song is sung, not one day before your dance is danced, not one day before your gift has been given. You have arrived on earth with a cargo. Everyone has brought a huge cargo. Everyone has brought gifts, talents, and capacities. Everyone has brought something to share and to circulate and to give and to be generous with. No one has arrived to get anything from the world. Listen to what I just said. No one has arrived to get anything from the world. Let's not get it twisted. You have come as a distributor of divine gifts to give to the world, to share, to shine, to glow, to radiate, to reveal, to source. You have come to give. Now here's the deal. You have a mind. You're not the mind. You have a mind. And you are here to, as I like to say, to take back your mind so it's no longer hijacked and programmed by worry, doubt, fear, and separation. And your premise every single day of your life is, I am, and I've got it all. I am, I've got it all. I am, I've got it all. And everyone who has it all in their right frame of mind, then the universal presence by means of its law operates through you, and you become a place through which more and more and more and more of the love and the harmony and the peace and the right action takes place in your life. Your destiny begins to unfold because you're not here to get from the world. You're not here to get, you are here to let. You're not here to get, you are here to let. You're not here to get, you're here to let the light shine. And out of no thing whatsoever, out of nothing whatsoever, but an idea of giving, an idea of sharing, an idea of becoming more yourself, an idea of unleashing your destiny, that vibrational match occurs and you unfold. That is, the idea within you unfolds to reveal its infinite nature. Are you picking up what I'm putting down here? Are you catching this? You catching it? Catching it?
Did you follow that? To listen to the subtleties of the emotions within you, so that you can gradually guide yourself to more and more thoughts about what you do want, so that your desires begin to feel good to you. Remember how good a desire felt when you were little, before others convinced you that you were selfish, or that you shouldn't have it, or that you couldn't have it, or that you weren't going to have it. We know you cannot see it, but you can sense it. But as we said earlier, it is subtle. You have to tune yourself to understand the subtleties of it. But once you hone in on it, then you will have control.
You call it clarity.
We call it satisfaction. You call it happiness. We call it satisfaction. You call it joy and appreciation and love, and we call it satisfaction, satisfaction, satisfaction. Because when you tune yourself to who you are so that you are not affecting any contradiction within you, when you stop that resistance and just allow all that you are to flow toward that which you are asking for, that's the satisfaction of life that you came to live. Often you say, I came to be a value to others, and you say, no, you came for that.